ads are so personal. Do you suffer from crippling social anxiety? Get paid to be part of our study. What? No! I'm a total social butterfly. Crippling anxiety. Psh, I mean, I can talk to anyone. I am great at talking to people.
Hello!
Are you 30 years old, single, wearing a brown tie, and just not realizing you don't have the means to support a family, nor the ability to convince someone to love you enough to marry you? Call and join our study. It's me, that guy. Okay? I'm just busy understudying as a knight at medieval times right now. That feature in 5 years, then I can start thinking about waking up. When I'm 35, acting at a restaurant.
This is the brown line train to the loop. Polite is next.
Afraid of growing old and depending on others to take care of your ass just like you have to do for your elderly parents? Call and join our study. Nah, I'm good. My life situation is dope. My folks are my best friends. Sure, they're needy and even into the best years of my life, but I owe them. I got it totally under control. Damn! Was that Addison? I need to pick up my mama's meds.
Is that guy looking at me? Why is he looking at me? Should I look at him? Or away from him? Or have my phone or something? Help. Help!
The lead knight will get hurt jousting and they'll be like, Clarence, this is your moment. Take the stage.
This is Polina. Southport is next.
Every day, thousands of orphans die from starvation. Are you doing enough? Jeez. I spent $60 on juice last week. Maybe I should do that thing my cousin did, the Peace Corps? Something without borders? Well, I've always wanted to take pictures with all those children in Haiti.
Did I put Dad's diabetic socks on him this morning? Oh, God. Oh, he's gonna stroke out.
Oh, my family. I just need to put myself out there.
Hi.
No. I'm paralyzed in fear.
Do you find yourself cracking jokes to avoid developing healthy emotional connections? Distract from your chronic tardiness? Or compensate for ego-depleting stretch marks and embarrassing snaggle teeth? Compensate? Take an improv class. What a very general ad. I bet half the people on this train fit those criteria. Not me, though. I got my adult braces off last month.
Belmont is next.
Oh, what a beautiful morning.
Stop the alien attack.
If my calculations are correct, we must go back to 1865, to the time machine!
Do it, Gary! Well, I thought that play was disastrous, but I love the parasol.
You owe me! You owe me! I don't care about the fucking parasol! No else I take to offense to fucking care with Miss Madeline!
All right, Jason, listen, we're all taking on roles.
Oh, yeah, and I was a slave? It's 1865, lady! No one would know who we really are!
Listen, Jason. We were all acting, performing, doing it for the good of the universe. Come on!
No, I am not your boy. My name is Jason Montgomery, all right? I graduated magna cum laude from Howard University. Did you forget I can have your job?
Jason,
Listen,
you were doing it for the good of the universe, and that's what counts. You really came into the role, right?
Hey, you were awesome out there. You picked the hell out of that talk.
Of the universe, Jason. This is what we're meant to do. Save everyone.
Yeah, come on. Dream team, hands in. Come on. Dream team.
Dream team.
Dream team. To be fair, you do need cotton babies left.
Who's my exact one?
BET, great cool.
Is this where you've been feeling
checking in at Portillo's because we're being quiet.
You don't have to worry. I did a little pop culture research.
And I have this Facebook.
I'm sorry, you did what?
Relax, we got this.
So I brought one bottle of wine, and I brought you the bigger mess.
So, did anybody see any good movies lately?
Yes, we saw that Get Out movie. Oh, white people, am I right?
Come on. I mean, I'm happy that it sparked a positive conversation.
Yeah, I mean, it's so crazy how people can be so oblivious.
We are very woke. I dated a black guy once.
You're a musician, right? Yes. Have you ever played any basketball? I mean, sports.
Well, actually, when I was younger, I used to play t-ball until my grandmother taught me how to play the piano. Now, in between recitals, I'm usually getting lessons at a local community center.
You look exactly like your grandmother.
I get that all the time.
I met John Legend once at a Quiznos.
He is married to Chrissy Teigen, who is Asian.
Make a baby, it's a Asian.
What are your intentions with our daughter?
Whoa. Okay, baby, you don't have cancer. Don't answer that.
Sorry, we're progressive. Even if you oopsie-daisy. I would love a baby golf prodigy. Tiger Woods, yo! Although he's not doing great right now.
I'm gonna go. I'm gonna go.
Hey, just get some of those apple kale ginger drinks, stop.
You like cold pressed juices?
Absolutely not. It's all like beet water. I mean, come on. Plus, what's the deal with turmeric? Am I right?
Greg just kind of stood around on your Facebook.
Yeah, a little bit. No, I can't even be mad at you, too. Actually, when I went to go get the wine, I actually did a background check on you, too.
Why would you do that?
I'll change it out. Twice.
Jeremy!
You second? You third? Whoever else you met, it's some disgusting Game of Thrones level bartender guy! And I would also like to point out that I am for certain that you hooked up with your ex-coworker, Lisa, in the bathroom!
You're the one who does all the real work out there. I mean, when I saw you riding on that motorcycle into the sunset, I could swear you were me from behind. Very, very far.
Kind of sad
when
I'm shooting a movie.
I know. Not ready for it to be done yet.
Hey, will you say the line one more time?
No, I couldn't.
Oh, come on, please. Just one more time for me. Old time sake.
I've got a hankering for some spankering.
Oh, it's like you've seen it 100 times and it never gets old. You're such a talent.
Oh, I mean, look at you. Without you, there's no life to this film.
No, no, no. It's you that people love. I mean, look at that face. There's something mean to say to you, but yeah, when I see you, I just think.
What are you saying, son?
It's so easy to stop my feelings, but so hard to speak them!
I have feelings for you too.
Really?
Yes. When I see you, I just want to say.
I'm not following you.
For the love of Tarantino.
Maybe we like try to say it at the same time. So when I look at you, it's like you did a back handspring, back tuck disc, and I'll first word ability until death drop touch me, become.
And when I see you, it's like I want to say, yes, absolutely, thank you. Well, you're wonderful too.
Oh. What are you saying to me? Well, this is useless. Listen, last few months with you, I felt like something out of a movie.
Could be hands on the credits roll.
Maybe. There's an M. Night Shyamalan twist no one saw coming. Oh, God, no! No, no! No,
hell no! Hell no! It's like kissing a less attractive, more agile version of myself.
Critics say, what were they thinking? Wait. One more for the road.
I've got a hankering for some spankering.
Okay, second graders, settle down. It's story time, and this week we're going to be reading The Very Hungry Caterpillar. Yay! And we have a very special guest here to read it, Kevin's dad. Mr. Edgar Allan Poe!
The Very Hungry Caterpillar. In the light of the moon, this egg lay on a leaf. Wonderful stuff. One Sunday morning, the warm sun came up, and poof, out of the egg came a tiny and very hungry caterpillar. Wretched sunlight. He started to look for some food. I cannot wait to see where this is going. On Monday, he ate through one apple, but was still hungry. On Tuesday, he ate through two pears, but was still hungry. On Wednesday, he ate through three plums, but was still hungry. What sort of boring dribble? By Thursday, his hunger was so overwhelming that he needed some flesh. Perhaps the flesh of his lost love, his beloved Beatrix. Maybe once he started eating her flesh, he would feel her love once more. Only then could they be reunited in life as well as death. Friday, he ate through her entire body. That night, he had a stomach ache. I wonder why. The next day was Sunday again. The caterpillar ate through one nice green leaf and felt much better. Though still in his heart, which roamed to Beatrix. Now he wasn't hungry anymore. And he wasn't a little caterpillar anymore. He was a big, fat caterpillar. Fat from his lover's flesh. He built a small house, around himself. Shutting himself off from a world without Beatrix. He stayed inside for more than 2 weeks, mourning his loss. Then he nibbled a hole in his poo, pushed his way out it, and he was a macabre butterfly, and we are just a light of midnight, smoking red out the ribs. I shall procure you from soccer clubs upon its completion. I will bring orange slices for the team to replenish your vitamin C.
No, but like, it is so much harder being a woman than people think.
Oh my gosh, I know, but first, can we please Instagram me shopping mimosas?
Oh my god, yes. Hashtag Marianas. No, but seriously, like, think about it. You're not even gay. We get catcalled as much as we do. Like, if we liked women too, we would get catcalled twice as much.
Oh my gosh. like constant catcalling and constant occasion. Like,
all
yes.
The time.
Oh my god. You are so smart. It's like a target on your back. But it's like, I don't know, like egos, you know? So.
Yeah, but only when girls do it, because then it's about like an outfit or something. But guys, it's just like.
Oh my gosh, it is just like Rosa Parks or pin figures?
Exactly.
I've reworked my calculations, and I know this time is right. We have to go back to 1916, to the time machine!
Do it to it, Gary!
That was...
No!
I mean, Shut up!
I didn't appreciate any of that, Gary. No. My hands are still... bleeding from a sweatshop, you goon!
You want a sharecropper now? Is that a promotion?
I'm starting to kind of feel where Jason's coming from. Not a lot, but a little bit. Employer spit on you just repeatedly over and over and over and over.
No one gives a fuck.
saw. All I want to do is pow, 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 and a click and a ching, and I take your money.
Can you do that one more time so we can post it to BuzzFeed when it launches? Get this. Pictures and videos.
Brad, don't make me do it again. Instagram, man.
Yeah, I'd be happy to sing it again. I mean, I love that song.
Really? You love that song?
Yeah. I love how someone so anti-gun could be enjoying it so much. I also love the part about getting money. Because if this country were in different hands, we'd be taxed so much, we wouldn't have $1.29 to buy the thing.
Guys.
This is so classic, you. I can't even begin to describe it. Listen, you make $1 billion an hour at whatever HR garbage ass job you have, and you can't give a little more than those less fortunate than you. That blows my mind.
But Sarah, how will you afford your daily grande loca macchiato if Daddy's debit card doesn't have any money on it?
It is a grande low-fat caramel macchiato. So educate yourself!
We worked hard to get to where we are.
Right, okay, yeah, and poor people don't work hard.
Nobody said that!
Well, this is what she does. She talks about things she knows nothing about. It's unnerving.
It is unnerving. How does Instagram beat me to the punch?
You know what the problem with this whole car is? You guys are just so privileged.
Oh, you're so privileged.
$2.
Rinse and repeat, of course you're worth it, big boy.
You have to try it not to yourself.
Free Wi-Fi!
And your cell phone battery lasts all day!
You have one dishwasher.
HBO Go password!
Whole milk!
You did change your underwear this morning.
Thank you for calling 1-900, you're fine.
Because even though the world's a dumpster fire,
the little victories are still wins.
to buy it. But it is on sale. $3 for $3 is a very good deal. May I help you?
Yes!
I was just wondering, do you find these earrings alluring? Honestly, I don't know if alluring is like the way I
would say it. Who's welcoming then?
Oh yes, I'm a lord and welcome. Into the basket you go with the lotion. Great, we have best friend bracelets on sale, 2 for $2. I'm supposed to say that. I've never worn one of those around my wrist.
Forever and ever. afternoon all. Are we all gay, which in this time period means happy?
We're super gay.
Well, I think I will have the burnt bread with a side of gravy. Matter of fact, give me half of the loaf with the gravy on top.
And I'll have the old stomach and a double portion of leather. But like half that. But don't hold back on the leather, love.
Mutton cooked well rare with a side of vegetables hand plucked from the northwest corner of the garden and hand washed with a rag that's been used more than once but less than thrice. Thank you, Mutton.
I will do that. The chef will have these things up as soon as he can, and may the god Crane and Henry VIII rule forever and ever and make England great again.
Hey, Clarence. What's got you looking so dapper today? New tunic.
Nope, just wash the one.
Yeah.
It's easy to look nice when you're sitting next to someone who doesn't put in the effort to put on shoes.
That's the beauty of middlemen. No. It's okay for the pomp and circumstance to mix around with the stock around the new pants.
What does your shirt say? Arrows by Roaring Fletcher.
Well, the point in brand recognition is to create a platform.
Stop trying to make flesh happen!
You three are queer, which means strange. Can I get you anything to drink?
Not so loud, love. I drank about a moat's worth of grog last night. Could I taper off with the bloody end bone in?
Comes the side of ale's ale, right?
As long as that ale has no end.
Orange juice with a sparkling
chocolate.
I'll just have a water. Oh, you three are a hoot. Just like our god King Henry VIII, who is not only the funniest man in the land, but his hands are so gargantuan they represent his manhood.
Feeling so adventurous.
Well, truth is, gents, I don't know how many more times I can join you for afternoon delight. Martha and I are thinking about having a child.
Oh, you're gonna start missing drunk facts!
No.
Okay.
I'm missing out on the most important part. You gonna have a child in this day and age?
Yeah, I mean, this country's leader is a ginger-haired egomaniac who constantly showcases insecurity and paranoia.
It's a scary world out there, but I'm 27, I'm three quarters of the way through life.
I'm afraid it was important to me.
Know what? I'm proud of you. Very proud of you. Let's just enjoy our time together with our Sunday fun day.
No! And it's not a no! I guess I'm just being selfish. I mean, I'm forgetting the three most important things in life. Eat, pray, grub.
You three are tighter than a bundle of sticks. Why, I could call you three fat.
To Brockfest!
I love how much thought you all put into it. I would have just called it brunch.
Well, here we are, Terminal C.
Yep.
You should go, you gotta catch a flight.
It's just so hard to say goodbye.
Baby, there are no goodbyes, only see you laters.
Okay, but you have to get up, get me out, because I can't do this without you.
Ha ha ha!
5-star passenger.
Everyone has that one bad friend in life. Their buddy, their pal, their mate. Just a wholesome bond between a boy and a girl, cause neither one wants to date. And sure, he's funny and really cute, and I bet he looks good in his birthday suit. But I love him like a brother, I love him like a bro, but sometimes I want to bone. Playing FIFA and drinking Bud Light. Oh yeah, we joke about farting and we get into tickle fights. He'll look at me and I'll look at him and he'll look away, but I'll look again. And I'll have some judgment. I'll whisper, maybe we should do it. But then I'm like, you're that one guy friend in my life. You're my buddy, my pal, my mate. This is a wholesome bond between a boy and a girl, cause we would never date. Ew! Sure, he's funny and really hot, and I cannot stop looking at his butt. But I love him like a brother, I love him like a bro, but sometimes I want to bone. My friends like to tease me. They tell me you're in love with him, but they're just super jealous of the totally platonic relationship I'm in. There's no romance in our little world. He even sometimes tells me about other girls. I actually like how he confides in me, but just out of curiosity, what do they have that I don't have? That Kirsten bitch you seem to like so much. She's gonna get stabbed. I'm the obvious pick. So throw me on your trundle bed and let me see your dick.
Guys, it's called an inside joke, and when you've had a good pal for as long as we've been good pals, you don't even get it. You don't understand. It's because it's like it's okay, for me to be like, you're like a little brother to me, like your tongue in my mouth, like. Just a wholesome bond between a boy and a girl, cause we could never date. And sure, he's perfect in everything to me, and we have this weird one-sided chemistry. But I love him like a brother, I love him like a bro, that I'm really trying to bone.
Finally. Don't forget to take another one in 6 hours.
Don't worry about me, okay, Mikey? Just go to Amber's party, I'll be okay.
Hey, Sue, I brought you something to eat. Oh, hey, Mike! Look at you, boy, looking all sharp. Let me take a picture. God damn, I can find my phone.
No, I think we're at Amber's house in like 10 minutes.
I thought you were going to a birthday party.
Yeah, that's where I'm headed. She's having a house party.
Oh, no. I thought you said you were going to the Cheesecake Factory.
No, Mom, I told you I was picking her up a cheesecake.
Just go to the Cheesecake Factory, okay? They have something for everyone. Okay? Oh, you know what? Oh, go to Cracker Barrel.
Cracker Barrel! Yeah! Oh,
it's cheaper. Oh, yeah. Amber doesn't live in a safe property. town. She lives in Pitchwater. Why didn't you fall in?
And the courage it takes you. The courage it takes you. You and Millet had no swim lessons, boy.
I wanted to see.
Chicago is criminals without borders, Mikey. We were coming up. We didn't have to worry about nobody getting shot while doing the soul train lock. Look at me go.
Yeah, not taking my girlfriend's adult party to a place that specializes in senior citizens and maniacs.
I got an idea. Why not? I drive you to the bar. We'll have fun. I still hit the fucking four corners. You know what? Let me just go get Amber's coffee table and we'll be right on our way.
No, that coffee table is ours now. You promised to fix it 3 years ago.
I just got a little on the legs. No problem.
Hi, Jeff. Nobody wants you going over to the party to play party security. I just fold. We're old. I get it.
I found my best pair of pants. They only got two holes in them. Now, check this out. I can even wear my union flannels. Yeah, here's the style.
Yeah, Dad, I think I'm good. I'm just gonna roll about you. And besides, you say you finished installing Grandma's sink.
Mikey! You cannot go. I saw an Amber alert.
Her name is Amber.
What if I just give you my credit card and you go and you rent a hotel room on the next mile?
What are you talking about, Susan? Oh, Jesus, finally slipped off your crap. We don't need no hotels when the board is rolling with me. Ain't that right? Home skillet biscuit, give me something. That's right. That's right. Now give me 5 minutes, let me go get my pistol.
Wait, what?
I thought we'd just keep it just in case.
Just in case what? Squirrel falls out of the chimney. Again.
Can y'all just please listen to me?
Just in case I got a lullaby, motherfucker, Susan.
Dad, could you please stop? You sound like you're auditioning for a comedy version of The Wire.
Mikey, just rent out the room, okay? You need some liquor? I'll buy it. Soon. If you need a little bit of that. That Mary's the one?
For some
I have some. I have extra.
What has got into you, Susan? What is wrong with you? The boy doesn't need your money for marijuana.
Come. Do you remember when you were a baby and you went to the movies and it was Poseidon and I felt like I was drowning because there were a man who was
after me? What?
No. What? Now, boy, don't worry about what I used to do. All right? It was a different time. Your dad was a draft out to animal back then. Okay? And back then, it's time the family stone had all of us believing that we're everyday people.
Okay, time out. This is too much to process. Okay? No. Mom, I have your meds ready for you every single morning, and Dad, I'm constantly making lunch for you. I would like just a break, an extended break from my loving helicopter parents.
Okay, Mikey, I understand. We understand. It's just every time you walk out the door, I'm so scared you won't come back alive. Like, just so scared.
That's all it is, Mikey. We just want you to be safe.
You know what? I have $17. You can get a cheesecake at Cheesecake Factory. Oh, if you go to the baker's store, you can get
it. Oh, yes. Silk.
Banana pie.
Yes.
Hey, I love you guys. To the moon and back.
To the moon and back. Hey, don't forget, save us a piece of that cheesecake.
Can I have all the car keys? All the way down the hall to your right.
Got it.
Enjoy your movie.
Thanks, you too.
miss those previews.
Yeah, totally. Hey, I'm so sorry. I know you're not also seeing the movie.
I said you too, out of habit. And that's hurtful.
No, it's my birthday and I'm stuck here at work, so I'm already bummed. I'm sorry I pushed you on the floor so hard.
No.
Street for
Stumble Up the Girl. Oh, man, she ain't even been on that street before.
She got hairy patches all over her body, sunken cheeks and no teeth. We call her Bitch Chewbacca on meth.
Ryan's mom is so fat she walked past the television and I missed 3 episodes of Breaking Bad.
Now the score's 45-30. One more completed serve and Andrea wins.
My mama is so stupid. She thought malaria, gonorrhea, and herpes were all Pokemon. The hood called them all.
There has never been a time in the history of the roast. Your mama jokes are no longer accepted. Only jokes about the other opponent. Final funniest joke wins. Dream Circus.
Brian Thelonious Simmons is such a dumb bitch. Melissa McCarthy does impressions of him on Saturday Night Live!
I'm sorry. I just got caught up in the heat of the moment. I'm sure that your mom is a wonderful lady. She created you.
What are you talking about, Ryan? Everybody knows I have 2 dads!
Can't be more mindful. Oh, stay free out, no heat at all.
I mean, bring a tote bag to the grocery store. Can I get foot beans?
I read this article about this girl who got her garbage down to 1 mason jar's worth. And I was like, wow, she had a lot of mason jars.
I love mason jars. Oh my gosh, my burrito bowls fit perfectly in them. Yeah, oh my gosh. You know, if everybody stored everything in mason jars, we would be able to build houses for all the refugees.
You are so...
It's just like what Frederick Douglass said at Coachella.
He is so horrible.
Early polling results are in.
That's what we were supposed to do.
That in the year 2300, the air would smell like cookie butter.
And hot dogs would roll off the trees.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure all Greeks have Swedish fish in them at this point. Which is ridiculous. You know, this is how life is supposed to be.
Bill Cosby is prohibited on CTA.
Kale apple ginger juice is prohibited on CTA.
Chronic masturbation is prohibited on CTA.
Annoyance.